10 o'clock, a victory for a man who has been fighting to clear his name. James Harris was sentenced to 25 years in prison for a crime that he said he did not commit. Now the Texas Criminal Court of Appeals has finally cleared his case and exonerated him. Our Brandon Walker has been following Harris's quest to clear his name. Brandon joins us live now from Northeast Houston. Brandon?
Good evening to you, Dominique. Dominique, joining you from near the location where the alleged crack house was, where a police officer said he saw Mr. Harris running, although we now know that wasn't the case, and it was how the officer identified Mr. Harris that proved key in the court's decision to throw this case out.
I read it every day, and it's the one that matters right here.
Every single time James Harris reads one letter, seven words.
We, the court, agree. Relief is granted.
Ring.
I just feel brand new. Like that. I feel brand new all the way around.
I was standing at this gate that particular day.
For 2 years, we've kept up with Harris, ever since his case went to the Texas Criminal Court of Appeals for review. In June of 2009, a Houston police officer accused Harris of running out of a drug house in Northeast Houston, netting him 25 years behind bars. Harris served 4 years, then made parole. Since then, he's worked to clear his name. There was no DNA link on the evidence used to convict Harris, and authorities now know the actual suspect. Also, the Houston police officer who ID'd Harris later testified in 2019 that he could have been wrong.
Maybe I was mistaken.
Harris read the officer's testimony for us when we caught up with him earlier this year. Now, Texas's Criminal Court of Appeals agrees. Police arrested the wrong man.
I got to start all over again.
Still, Harris says he has years of lost time for which he won't be able to make up, with his mother, children, grandchildren. He's ready to try, though, and pushes others still fighting to follow his lead.
I don't care how long it would have took me. I was going to keep scratching and keep clawing.
Mr. Harris still waiting for the final paperwork to come. He did tell me, though, that this morning he had his last scheduled meeting with his parole officer. Live on the Northeast side tonight, I'm Brandon Walker, KPRC 2 News.